continue the derivative approach to military service. And this is the third result. So to remind you, our system is hybrid of conscription and voluntary system. In Korea, every healthy Korean male should serve 20 months. And then my suggestion is that after 10 months, we give option to a private, a soldier. Then he can decide discharge or continue. If he choose continue, then he receive $20 million and continue the service 10 months more as a senior soldier, corporal and sergeant. So that's my basic idea. So we show the results, what is the people's response to this hybrid service. And I showed a couple of results, and the third result is that next, I asked another question to responders that we ask what all responders think is a socially desirable strike price. Suppose a society, Korean society offer a soldier to work 10 months more as a soldier, what would be a socially desirable strike price per month? So, for example, if a respondent answered 2 million won, he believed that a soldier should receive 2 million Korean won per month if the soldier chooses to serve for the military 10 months more as a corporal and sergeant. Thus, this question measures the subjective and social valuation on the monthly strike price. It also assesses how much our hybrid system is socially implementable. So the larger the number, the higher the society praises the sacrifice in military service, the more costly to implement the hybrid. Now table 3 shows the result. So mean average is around 2 million Korean won, which is $2,000, so much less than like $1,800 per month. So many people believe this is a socially desirable amount. How do you think? Is it reasonable? Yes. Yeah, so, here's their answer. Table 3 shows the result, and then it is mean, and then I regard it as subjective socially accepted strike price per month as a dependent variable, and I did regression analysis, and this is finding. The mean of socially accepted monthly option strike price is around 2 million won, around 20 million for later 10 months. It is purely a coincidence that this 20 million Korean won matches the number appearing in our first survey question. Remember, in my first survey question, I asked, if a government offers 20 million won, will you serve? Will you continue to the service? Our best guess is that Korean men in their 20s regard the time in the military as a foregone labor income. Since this number is also consistent with the average age of this young male group, our estimate can reflect the opportunity cost of the expected military extended military service. So this 2 million won per month or 20 million for later 10 months is not a coincidence. People answer this is socially desirable because it is the opportunity cost, usual average wage for young Korean men. In addition, interestingly, those who have finished military service tend to regard the desired strike price like $600 less. So this is surprising. Remember, it is huge money, right? So monthly, socially desirable monthly salary is $2,000. And those who finished the military service, so they regard it is like $600 less. So which means that for the pre-service group, it is like $2,300 per month. And then those post service group, it is $1,700. So this is huge difference. I was kind of surprised. So those post military service groups, so they tend to, how can I say? They say we don't have to pay that much money for the extended 10-month service. I think this is very interesting. How will you interpret this result? So those if we compare pre-service and post-service group, I mean, this is a lot. I mean, why is that? Why? Any interpretation? Why those post-service group believe the socially desirable amount is much less?굉장히 재미있는 결과입니다. 아무튼 군대 갔다 온 사람들이 그렇게까지 많이 줄 필요 없다. 군대 별거 아니다 이렇게 생각하는 건지 막상 갔다 온 사람들 지나오던 미워해서 가기 전엔 두렵고 Another interesting result is that Seoul residents, if you live in Seoul or if your archaeology major is literature and business, they tend to lower the strike price by this amount. So this is not small. Intuitively, those expecting military service require high strike price because they face higher uncertainty. The more the downside risk in human capital, the larger the required insurance payment, equivalently by Foucault parity. The more the upside potential human capital, the larger required strike price in order to keep the corrosion value constant. So this is my interpretation. If you don't go to military yet, you have higher certainty. So it means that you have some higher certainty, you require some premium on the uncertainty. Therefore, they regard the strike price higher. They believe the strike price should be higher. Anyway, this result is consistent with the fact that call or put option, fact that call or put option values increases with uncertainty. If you learn derivative pricing class, you will learn that call option and put option price tends to increase with uncertainty. And I believe this result matches that finding in derivative literature. If you face higher uncertainty as a pre-service group, then you require more exercise price because you believe the option is more valuable. And the remaining result look consistent with those in table 2. The only difference is the result for literature major. This result reveals one aspect of the Korean labor market. These days, a college graduate with a literature major experiences extreme hardship in job market. It is true, isn't it? Do you agree? So you are lucky because your major is business and economics. But if your major literature, I heard it is very hard to get this job. It is sad, but the value of the call option in hand tends to decrease if one has a poor outside option to which our results correspond. So because you have a poor outside option, you think you can accept less money. Okay. Now discussion. Okay. Of course, there are a lot of limitations and issues about my suggestion, so there should be some discussion about that. First is the value creation mechanism and enlistment supply. This section presents an alternative preference mechanism on how our hybrid system is an improvement over voluntary system, i.e. more efficient. There is much heterogeneity in youth preference for military service, and preference heterogeneity by itself makes the supply curve of new recruits relatively inelastic. However, the literature is silent on how preferences are formed and how well informed your youth are about their preference prior to entering service. You don't know whether you will like the military service or not. Of course, it is very unlikely that you like military service, but before you experience, you don't know how much you will dislike the military group. So there is a preference uncertainty, that is a problem. So the relative efficiency of my hybrid system emerges depending on how well informed the youth are. Now suppose there is much uncertainty in the youth population about their preference for military service, such that prior to actual service, youth are likely to overstate the negative aspect of service and underappreciate the positive aspect. Is it true? Before you go to the military, you tend to exaggerate negative sides and underestimate the positive side. Do you believe so? I think so, given my experience. Once you finish the military service, for your remembering self, it is kind of doable. Sometimes it was not so fun, but sometimes it is not entirely such a disaster. But before you go to the military, you are like going to hell sometimes. So you exaggerate the negative side of it. So as preference uncertainty exists and preferences are downside biased, the supply curve of new recruits to the left is to the left of where it would be if the youth were fully informed of their preference, right? Because they're so negative. Hence, preference uncertainty raises the cost of a volunteer system because it increases the military wage necessary to meet the given demand for new accessions. Because people have overestimate, exaggerate negative side, military should pay more if we want to operate the volunteer system. The hybrid system creates value as follows. Bring in substantial number of draftees for a relatively short training period and expose them to military life. Then set the price to induce some desired fraction to continue service. Okay. Therefore, if there is a lot of uncertainty in youth preference for service, those preferences are download bias, and the drafted discover their true preferences during the initial period, and then a hybrid system has the potential to reduce cost relative to a volunteer system by reducing the wage rate needed to satisfy a given force strength requirement. Does it make sense? Of course, other factors such as recruiting and training costs would count in the analysis in order to establish the relative efficiencies of the system quantitatively. Okay. And then there are empirical issues. Okay, I think I can skip these because they are somewhat technical. Okay, next, optimal design problem. So our hybrid system allows anyone who prefers not to be in the military to leave, but the military may prefer keeping them. Of course, such problem would be more severe in voluntary system, less severe in our hybrid system, and not present in the at least for 21s under the current conscript. It is information asymmetry problem I mentioned. Once government offer money and want to find a volunteer for the service, they will find that those least desirable, least unwanted candidate will apply for the position. And that problem will be very severe in voluntary system, less severe in hybrid system, and not present in the conscription system. In the conscription system, because everyone should serve, there's no adverse selection problem. High ability and highly educated individual might prefer not to be in the military because of high opportunity cost, i.e. e.g. high earnings or good education opportunities outside the military. However, the military might prefer to refrain these individuals, right? Those are also individuals highly want because their capability. Thus, an optimal design for the hybrid system needs to balance moral hazard and opportunity cost benefit of keeping high ability personnel in the military instead of the civil sector. And then there is also highly related with information asymmetry problem with signaling game. If you took game theory, I think you may learn the signaling game, and the signaling game is very, very influential framework. The option is available only to the conscripts that the military wants to keep at the optimal maturity. So military offer the option to those soldiers that they want to keep. Thus, to implement a hybrid system efficiently, the military must identify who is a good soldier and who is a bad soldier. Identify those it wants to keep. Then this can create a signaling game situation. A poor candidate, right? A poor candidate can play a high performer. So they disguise, although they are not so good, they disguise they are good. Candidate play high performance and try to qualify for the option. For example, every firms want to find good people for their new employee, right? For their new employee, and then so they do like interview and they require TOEIC, TOEFL score, test score. Like statement of the cover letter, something like that. They require a lot of documents to tell whether someone is good or not. But problem is that every applicant of the new job pretend they are very good. I am highly exceptional person, so please hire me, something like that. So everyone signal that they are very good. So that is a challenge for employer. How they can tell the good person and bad, not good or bad. How they can tell highly valuable employee or less valuable employee. In the situation in which everyone pretended they are so good. One possible idea is to check the grade of the university. I mean, everyone knows that grading in universities maybe not so related to job quality. Quality of a person in the actual situation, right? Of course, learning finance and accounting is exceptional. Finance and accounting is a hard skill, okay? But things like other classes, they are not so related with the quality actual work in the job. But then, still firms require applicants to present their grading in the university. Why is that? Because the argument is like this. The underlying economics is like this. Everyone wants to pretend they are good candidate, a valuable employee. But if their ability is low, If ability is low, it is more and more difficult to pretend they are good, right? If ability is not so good, of course you can boost up your TOEIC score, TOEFL score, and something like that. But if your ability is not exceptional, it is harder and harder for you to increase TOEIC and TOEFL score. University grading is the same. Everyone wants to pretend they are good, but if you are not good, it is more and more difficult to keep good grade for the 4 years in the college. Therefore, this is very interesting. Although, in the extreme case, even if what you learn in university is completely useless, if that completely useless class is more costly for the less valuable people to get good grade then the more valuable candidate, that still it can be a signaling device to employer. Because although it is completely useless, anyway, for the less smart people, it is hard to get good grades. Therefore, by looking at their grade, they can tell whether someone is good or not. So it is one explanation why education is necessary. Although education is completely useless, still it can provide the signaling. It can tell who is good or who is bad. Like university, someone goes to good university. In Korea, there is some hierarchy in universities. Yeah. It is disappearing now. It disappears more and more. Like 10 years ago, 20 years ago, it was much more strict. And the hierarchy of Korean university is much more blurred now. It is not so sharp. Like 10 or 20 years ago, it was very strong hierarchy, but not so much anymore. But anyway, still, because the, which university you go can be a good signal, because everyone knows that once you go university, I mean, eventually what matters in the company is their ability. Which university you don't go is less relevant, possibly. But thing is that if you don't go good university, it means that you study very hard in high school, which tells something about the employee. Okay, maybe they have a good learning skill, or they are very hardworking, something like that. So tell something like that. So even if university education is completely useless, and the hierarchies of universities completely useless, possibly, in actual job performance, still, it can be a useful signaling device, even if it is completely useless. Okay. So, this is similar. A poor candidate can play high performance and try to qualify for the option. This paper does not formally analyze or separate, so separating in equilibrium. So this is called the separating equilibrium, which means that in separating equilibrium, smart people study hard and go to good university. Less smart people, maybe it is too costly for them to study very hard and to go good university. They don't study and go to less good university. So there is separation. In university, some good students, they study very hard and they good grade. But other students, less smart students possibly, they know it is too hard for them to get good grade. It is too costly for them, so they don't study that hard and they get bad grade. So good student study. So it does not mean if you study hard, you become a good student. No, it is not actually true. If you good study, your strategic action is to study and signal. If you are not good student, then you don't study and you don't have the signal because it's too costly. Study does not make you good student. Good student study hard. So that is one mechanism of universities. So that's called the separating equilibrium. Depending on the type of your ability, you choose your signaling action. However, this paper does not formally analyze a separating equilibrium in which the types of concepts truthfully reveal their ability. Reveal their ability by working hard for first 10 months. However, if it is costly enough, so this is my argument, if it is costly enough for a poor candidate to play a high performer, then they will be separating an intuitive equilibrium. I.D. the first 10 months can be a training and observation period, while the rest 10 months is a job market. So we can regard this like a job market situation. That's why all the firms want to look at your grade, which classes you took. Nowadays, more and more firms look at which courses you actually took, because they know it is much easier. Because firms are also smart, and they know which classes are hard classes and which classes are easy classes. And they know poor candidate, it is too costly for poor candidate to take hard classes. But for good candidate, they can afford the hard classes. So there is a separating equilibrium. Good students choose hard classes. Bad students choose less easy classes. So there is a separation. And the firm uses that information to hire you. And then next one is the reserve army and skill. We interviewed several military officials. The officials expressed concerns on the budgetary implication. Of course, it costs money, so military people may don't like it. In addition, they concerned that system can weaken the reserve force, 예비군. In Korean, in the geopolitical situation of Korea, the reserve army is very, very important. Once you discharge, you become a reserve army. So those two guys in front, all Korean male under, I forgot the age. What is the 예비군 age? 5 years. So after their discharge, for the next 5 years, they belong to the reserve army. So they are not in the military, but they have to take training periodically for the next 5 years. That is strategically very important in South Korea. Thing is like this, suppose there is war between North and South Korea, then the calculation is that after 10 minutes, actually, you know the DMZ, right? So this is Korea, right? This is Korea and this is DMZ, right? Exchanges, have you been to the DMZ? No. So this is DMZ. It is a good place to visit, DMZ. And then DMZ is very important, right? So about 70, I forgot exact number, but 70 or 80% of the regular soldiers are in this area, right? It is natural, right? And the calculation is, so here we have 70 to 80% here. So the thing is that suppose there is war between North and South Korea, and after 10 minutes, about 70 or 80% of the soldiers will die. Right? And most of them will die anyway after the war. And then what should happen? Now it becomes important to reserve army. Reserve army here, they have to fight with the guerrillas of North Korean guerrillas possibly, right? And they have to maintain the order and law and order of the society, something like that. So reserve, and then after they die, then they go again and they fight. Something like this. This is the way it works. So reserve army is very, very important in case of war, because regular soldiers will die quickly. And the problem is hybrid system. So thing is like this. Discharging a soldier is not the end of military service in Korea. In the current situation, the reserves, 예비군, called 예비군, are strategically important. Therefore, the military should ensure that all soldier is skilled enough at discharge. Military should provide, okay? Military, in the military, soldiers should protect the country. That's the number one mission. Next mission of the military is to produce good reserve army. To the extent, 10 months appear short to produce useful reserve forces. For example, a soldier may not even complete one ranger, which is called 유격훈련, one extreme weather training, called 혹한기훈련, training during his service. One extreme weather. Okay. Some officials argue that it takes around 15 months for the infantry to be skilled, and the longer for artillery and tanks specialist. In addition, those soldiers in the strategic important but difficult tasks can be less likely to stay in the army. Some soldiers are in the very hard, working in DMZ is very hard. And those soldiers are least likely to continue, although they are most important. So that's the problem. Yeah. And then some argue that the leadership skill, leadership also matters. Like soldiers should have leadership. Right? the leadership skills materialize at the transform from private first class to corporal, from 일병 to 상병. That transition period is most important to learn leadership skill. Do you agree? Right? 병장 is like somewhat different. 상병 is working very hard, right? 상병, corporal should lead 삽질 or yeah, something like that. So that's the most important period. Yeah. Around, exactly around option maturity. In order to address those budgetary concerns and skill acquisition, we clearly need to implement the hybrid system, flexible and varied depending on context. Next subsection discusses this issue. Given the aforementioned practical issues, we can introduce a varied version of the hybrid system. First, we can delay the exercise price like 15.15516 fourth play. For example, we can ask, do you want an early discharge or do you wish to stay on as a sergeant for the 5 months at 10 million Korean won? Something like that. So it is variation. Future study can undertake a comprehensive survey with more flexible exercise data. So we can, it is like a 10-10 split, but we can make it variation. You can make it various. Second option should take into account the different specialties and strategies. If we work in DMZ, maybe they can offer more. For example, the option should be different for those stationed in the front line versus the non-front line. This is DMZ. Versus a non-front line or different branches. If you work in church, for example, just cleaning the church in your job in military, if you're cleaning the church, then maybe people don't want you to stay long. And they will not open it. But if you are in DMZ, maybe they have to pay more. So conclusion. This paper presents a novel hybrid military system that combines conscription and voluntary military services. This hybrid incorporates a real option. In the Korean context, we suggest the strike price of the option as $20,000 on average. In order for a Korean soldier to extend his military service 10 months more, a government can use this hybrid system in order to implement a social insurance against unemployment, to recruit experienced candidates, to prevent incapable soldiers from staying in the military and to reduce moral hazard information asymmetry. Future study can analyze our idea further to check whether it is implementable and how to implement it. They can examine the other active soldiers, not just the pre-Soviet post-service mail. Nevertheless, we demonstrate how real option and organization research can identify research opportunities and contribute to the design of the civic duty and to further community value. Future study extends this line of research. Okay, so any question about this one? So this is the, I like this topic. I think this is important research idea because it's my idea as well. And I think this, I deliberately chose this paper because it includes a lot of interesting concepts like call option, put option, real option, and information asymmetry, adverse selection, signaling game, moral hazard. Because they are all very important concepts. So any question? Any question about the moral hazard information asymmetry or jump market signaling, something like that? Okay, thank you, and I think this is enough for today, and see you on Monday.